Claire Spaulding, and you're watching my weekly vlog for My Brand Story. Your space to be to build a truly authentic business and brand that will connect like electricity. Have you ever wondered why it is you love a business so much, or a brand, or a product, and you can't identify what it is? That, my dear friend, is a tribe member. You are their target market and their tribe member. Want to know a little bit more about that? As I say week after week, it's about a strong brand is about building a connection with the target market, knowing exactly what it is that drives them and connecting with them in this hot spot, this emotional heat. It's really, really important, and it's something that we overlook. We think about all the practical, but we don't nail the emotional connection because it's not something that's obvious. But with brands that do, they truly connect and they have people for life. And that is what I call a tribe member. It is someone that's part of your tribe that will sing it to the world. Want to know a little bit more? Let me start right at the back. Okay. And it's a question I'd like you to sit down and ask yourself about your consumers. When I go through these steps, think about that. And think about it, you'll know if you have a tribe, you'll have a supportive following, people constantly commenting on how positive it is, you know, your purchases, repeat purchases, that's a key thing. You have a repeat purchaser, that's on your way to a tribe member. But I'll start from the beginning. All right, so step one, these people are indifferent. They're not one, they're not the other. In all honesty, they have no real opinion. So they're really just, they'll take it if it's there, they'll leave it if they don't want to. They don't have any emotional connection. Really. So for me, an example of a brand like that, and I'm a bit of a brand junkie, so I have to think about this. I'd probably say my toilet paper. I'm indifferent. Now, not to say that if you do sell toilet paper that you can do that, because look at Sorbent. They created this gorgeous brand with the golden retriever, not Labrador, and they started building an emotional connection. And there's also this funny thing now called the Squatty Potty. Look it up. Hilarious video about something that's not overly glamorous, but builds tribe members. So don't just think if you have a product that it is. But for me, toilet paper is pretty low on my spectrum. Not always, not for all people. My friend loves the wet ones because for her, it's all about that feeling of, I'm not sure. But for me, toilet paper, meh, indifferent. Look on the shop, whatever's the best price, I'll take it. And usually bulk, so I don't have to do it regularly. Then you go to step two. All right, a little bit more. They like it. So the next step is like. They like it. They don't hate it. They're not indifferent. They're not flat. There's a little emotional connection. But realistically, they don't think too much about it. But there is an element of positivity. So with a like, what do I like? What do I like? What is a brand that I like? See, I'm extreme. I'm like indifferent or love. I need to look around, I need to have a think. My current shampoo, John Frieda. I'm at a place now where I don't need to be excessive with my shampoo. It does the job, it ticks the box, it's not too expensive. I like it, it does the job. I wouldn't rave about it. Like I have in the past, I've fallen in love with shampoos and conditioners, but right now, not a priority. So my John Frieda shampoo and conditioner, I like it. I use it. It does the job. I'll purchase it again. Done. That is like. Now for step three, we're moving a little bit more emotion. The heat is warming up inside. Not so cold, wet fish. Not so lukewarm, but a warm heat inside of me. Love. Love it. It's the next step. What is a business or a brand that I love? It's that you love it, you purchase it, you're a repeat offender, you're constantly purchasing it, but you probably don't go to the next level and talk about it. but it's something that you love. For me, I would say something that I use absolutely every day, and I love, love, love my Majora English breakfast tea. My Majora English breakfast tea. I use it, I probably have 4 cups of tea a day. Oh, speaking of, today, Earl Grey, tea too, of course. So I have my Earl Grey today. This is so yummy with honey. Tea too, I'm probably a tribe member, but we'll get back to that. But Majora, my everyday product. I drink it, I consume it 4 times a day. It's the first thing I have in the morning. But it hasn't built an emotional connection with me. It's emotional because I love it and I love the taste, but there's nothing beyond that. I don't want to scream to the stars about it. So it sits this lovely, lovely place of love. You've got me forever, Majora. I'll be purchasing forever. But that's where it sits. I don't talk about it, except with you guys, just lucky ones. And then there's the next one. So you go from the flat, lukewarm, warmish inside, your heart melts when you drink it, or consume it, or see it, or whatever. And then we go to tribe member. That, my friend, is brand gold. You get yourself a tribe member, they're your tribe for life. And the tribe members, they tell everybody how much they love it. Third person endorsement, it's so important. So these guys, tribe members, they're outwardly passionate about the brand. They're outwardly telling everyone how much they love it because they feel like that aligns with their personal brand. This brand lifts their personal brand and it touches everything that's important. So, you know, all their key priorities. So for me, I'm a tribe member for definitely T2. And I'm going to tell you right now, I resisted it for so long because I do consider myself a bit of a tea snob. I love my tea. I find I do talk a lot more about it now, and I never used to. I just loved consuming it. It's a very personal thing for me. And I thought T2 was gimmicky. And then I tried it. And then I went in there. And for me, T2 at all points gets me. Their product is really good quality. Their packaging is really good. Their whole story is strong. It's authentic. It connects with me. It connects with what's important to me. So in turn, I tell everybody, including you guys, how much I love it. And I'm telling you right now, I'm not paid to. This is me saying I love T2. And I'm a tribe member, and I will. It'd take a lot for them, maybe a scandal, I don't know, for me not to be a tribe member and not to tell everybody how much I love it. That's gold, because you cannot pay for that. You just can't. You cannot pay for that. So that's a really important thing. I'm also a tribe member for NARS, which I've spoken about before. Apple, you know what, BKR. I am a tribe member, and I'm usually very vocal about things that I love, and that could be my personality, but you'll find that most people are, because when they find something they love and it aligns with their personal brand, they are telling everybody. So, where does your brand sit with your target market? Have you thought about it? Have you thought about what emotional connection you have with them? I talk about this in my brand pack. It is a part of one of the weeks because it's about cutting through and building a personality. So it's a little snippet of it. One quote that I love from my brand hero, or one of the brands that I love, it is from Steve Jobs, and I'm gonna read it. When you touch someone's heart, that is limitless. Think about it. Like that with person, and I know that I go back to it. A brand is like a person. If you can keep reiterating that in your head, a brand is a person. If you can keep thinking like that, once you connect with somebody, it's limitless what you can do because you've connected. They're core of core. And if you can continue to do that and be authentic in your narrative, in your communication, in the way you present, and consistent, then you have them for life. T2, they've got me for life. Because they tick my important parts. So what I would go, if I was you, and I'd have a little sit down and I would think about, what are you communicating? How are you communicating it? And then look at your target market, if you haven't already. And what is it they are looking for? What is it they need? How can your brand align with their personal brand? And then build this marriage that is so strong. And you cannot get ambassadors, influencers. It's so different. You get authentic, real people telling everybody they know about something they love, your business, your brand, and that is gold. It beats all the advertising, all the SEO, everything, all the social media that we spend so much time on. If you can nail that, you've got gold, honestly. So on that, it's a short, sweet one. Tribe member, think about it. Who are your tribe members? Firstly, who are your target market if you haven't done that already? Look at a few vlogs behind. And also, look at my brand pack. This brand pack I have built to clean up all the crap and to target really important features that you need to know when targeting businesses, when targeting your target market, when communicating. It's a consolidated pack for all small businesses and large at any stage of their brand or their business. If you're starting out, if you're halfway through, you need a strong brand direction and a brand story. And that is why I created it. And knowing what your tribe member is, it sounds weird and it's probably something you've never even thought of. But it's vital in the DNA of a strong brand. So have a think about it. So wrapping it all up, knowing your target market and how to truly connect with them will then build tribe members, lifelong partners that won't go anywhere else. Really important. Have a think about it. Do you have tribe members? So that was my tip for the week. Feel free to subscribe to my weekly vlogs. Leave a comment below. Let's start the conversation. Do you have tribe members? Ask me any questions. I'm here to answer. I'm here to help you get your business off the ground. Want to know more about my 5-week brand pack? Pop over to my website, mybrandstory.me, to find out all about it and how to lift your business to the next level and build a truly authentic connection with your target market. Also on the website, sign up for the free 20-point branding checklist to see where you stand with your target market and then where you can go. It's free, it's from me, check it out. Stay true to your journey and your brand story because what you have to offer is truly authentic and nobody else has that. Honestly, remember that and you'll keep going and you'll keep pushing it. I'm Claire Spaulding. Thank you for watching this week's vlog. And I'll see you next time on My Brand Story weekly vlog. See ya. Bye. And you're watching my weekly vlog. What's that again? Spaulding. From what you're well. Hiya. Weekly vlog. I don't even get this. Winging your dead horse. Vlogging, I don't know. It's actually not a nice phrase.
Yeah, it looks. I feel like it's left me from belly to belly. But I like this.
So wrapping it all up.